It's the Yes, We're Here edition of Forbes Sports Money. Bob Lorenz, Michael Ozanian with you. Ozzy, let's talk about The Last Dance. It is a riveting documentary that's out right now on ESPN. It's about Michael Jordan, the billionaire Michael Jordan. You excited about this show?
Bob, I saw the first episode. Great show. And you mentioned billionaire. I think really that's the big picture of how valuable the MJ brand is. MJ is the richest athlete on the planet. He's worth $2.1 billion. To give you a little context, Bob, the second richest athlete is Tiger Woods, whose net worth is $800 million.
So we know with MJ, it's about the long game, right? So he's accumulated that $2-plus billion over a very long career, which has really had a variety of lives, right? On the court and then off the court. And now his biggest investment in his portfolio is the Charlotte Hornets.
That's right, Bob. He owns 70% of the Hornets. He took control in 2010 for $175 million price tag. The team now is worth $1.5 billion. MJ owns 70% of that. That accounts for about half his net worth.
And we always say, thank you, Steve Ballmer. Right? Every NBA owner.
And those big fat TV deals.
Yeah, right. That $2 billion check for the Clippers, it helped every team. So it certainly helped Michael Jordan. But here's the interesting thing. He played in an era where he made a really nice income. But that's far from the story. The story is the endorsements, right?
Yeah, he played before the big salary hit. I mean, during his entire career, I say only, he only earned $98 million in salary. Give you an idea of how things changed for him. In endorsement income over his career, he's earned $1.7 billion to date. And just last year, his endorsement income was $145 million.
Wow. And it keeps pouring in, you know, mainly, right, courtesy of Nike and the Air Jordan brand that he's built.
Yeah, he gets a royalty plus an endorsement check from Nike. And Nike is still such a powerful shoe brand in the U.S. They have 86% of the U.S. basketball performance shoe market. And in dollar terms, the fourth quarter of last year was their biggest quarter ever.
And you talk about, I know we're in a different environment right now, but every time that new pair of Air Jordans comes out, right, people are lined up around the block to get them.
Yeah, what I find amazing is, Bob, is that, you know, there's this Q score, which we've discussed and you're familiar. It basically measures the appeal of athletes. Of any male athlete, either retired or playing, Jordan has the highest Q score. And what's incredible to me is if you dissect the number further, he's most popular. He has the best appeal among teenagers. These are people who never even saw him play.
Right. It's weird, right? Because you'd say, well, that makes no sense. They weren't even born when he was playing, or maybe they were just in diapers. And then all of a sudden, he's so popular among them. It just shows how well he's built his brand.
Right. And part of that, I think, besides his image and with shows like The Last Dance, which is their last championship season, is some of the sponsors and endorsements he's aligned himself with, you know, blue chippers like McDonald's, Coca-Cola, among others. So the name recognition he's got with those has been fantastic.
You know, it's amazing, too, to see. We knew how great he was. You and I were able to see him play. Oh. But when you see this documentary, you're reminded just how transcendent a player he was.
Yeah, there's no other comparison. You know, I don't want to give away my age here, but in all the years I've watched basketball, I can't remember any other time period where one player was so much better than all the others. You know, I mean, I had the era of the great Knick teams when they won the championship. Right. Of course, you know, you had Willis Reed and the great John Havlicek and those players, and then Julius Erving. But even with Bird and Magic, you had two, three guys that were sort of around the same.
Right.
With MJ, he was so much better than everybody else, and perhaps even to this day.
It's a great documentary to watch if you're caught up in the who's better, Michael Jordan or LeBron James. This will at least give you some context, right? Like, oh, I didn't know he played like that. I mean, there are some young kids that are going to see him kind of playing for the first time.
Yeah, and I also think that, you know, as part of his great marketing acumen, Bob, this keeps his brand fresh. You know, obviously you see the commercials, the endorsements, and you get to see MJ during the basketball season. But you know what? There is no basketball season right now. Like, there's no other sports season. So it keeps his brand fresh right there in front of you.
Yeah, it is interesting, too. They moved the documentary up a couple months to kind of fill that gap. It was supposed to air in June. By the way, he is getting paid, so to speak, for the documentary, but he's not taking any money. Tell us about that.
No, I think this is another very smart thing that helps his brand. And I'm not saying that's the only reason he does it, but his take would have been probably between $3 to $4 million. He's giving that all to charity. You know, just like in the Charlotte area where his basketball team is, he's putting close to $10 million on two hospitals down there that serve underprivileged children. So he gives a lot back. And when you do the right things in terms of philanthropy, he's also big in the Make-A-Wish Foundation.
Yeah.
You know, it also really helps your brand.
And outside the charitable side as well, he is involved in some smaller investments. What are those?
Well, I think his investments in the future are going to be things that are going to add to his net worth in a considerable amount. He's involved in esports through the investment in Axiomatic. Team Liquid is the esports team that he's an investor in. It's one of the most valuable esports teams in the world. I peg the value at about $320 million. But my favorite investment for MJ is a company that you and I have profiled, Sport Radar, right? They do all the data in sports and the manipulation of the data and stuff. And where is that going to be huge? With sports betting. As legalized sports betting grows, the value of Sports Radar is going to continue to grow.
By the way, the one investment that might not be paying off now, but there is that Nike and Air Jordan connection, Michael Jordan, Derek Jeter with the Miami Marlins.
Yeah, well, we never let anybody go unscathed on our show, Bob, so MJ will be no exception. Yeah, he became a small investor in the Marlins when Jeter bought the team for $1.2 billion. But as you know, they've really been terrible on the field. They were last in baseball in attendance last year. They barely averaged over 10,000 fans. Their local TV deal never materialized, their new deal. They haven't been able to sell the naming rights. So we downed the value to $980 million. In our last go around a couple of weeks ago. So that's one area where he has a tiny blemish on. But when you're worth $2.1 billion, I think you can get over it.
Not putting too much of a dent in that $2 billion. It's going to be okay, is what you're saying.
I think so, Bob.
All right. Thanks, Ozzie.